Welcome to the demonstration of Tzunami Deployer. During this demonstration, we'll perform a migration from SharePoint 2010 to SharePoint 2013 using Tzunami Deployer. This presentation will go over the four main steps of the migration process. First, we'll connect to our source, SharePoint 2010, and load all source content. Next, we'll repeat this process to load our target SharePoint 2013 content. We then perform the virtual deployment along with all of its relevant configurations. And finally, we'll commit our migration specifications to our target SharePoint 2013 environment. We'll start by creating a new deployer project. When we click on File, New, Deployer will create a new project for us to work on. We are prompted to give our project a name. We will call it SharePoint 2013 Migration. Next, we specify the project folder using the Browse button. Here we choose our source and target systems from the list. For this demo, we're choosing to deploy from SharePoint 2010 and deploy to SharePoint 2013. Our new project is now ready for migration. As you can see, a deployer project is divided into two areas. The top area is for the source content. In our case, the content that will be loaded from SharePoint 2010. And the bottom area is for the target SharePoint 2013. In the source panel of Deployer, we'll load the data from our source SharePoint 2010. This is done by clicking the Connect button on top or by right-clicking the source panel and then Connect to SharePoint. We now have the connection wizard. When we click Next, we are required to specify the connection details. First, we'll fill in our server address. This can be done by entering the server's name or IP address. To make sure you have the correct information, please consult with your system administrator. Next, we enter our credentials. The user connecting to SharePoint must have sufficient privileges in order for the deployer to write the changes to SharePoint. Please refer to our Tzunami Deployer user guide for more information regarding permissions. After the connection to the SharePoint server was made, we choose which web applications we would like to load into our project. We are now able to decide how we would like to load our SharePoint structure. First, we choose which site collections we wish to load to our project. When the Read Subsites option is checked, Deployer will read all subsites under the site collection. For this demonstration, we'll select the site collection named Demo. Under the Content tab, we can choose to read none of the lists, only the libraries, or all of the lists. The same applies for reading items. We can read none of the items, the latest version only, or all versions. When no sites and no lists are selected, the loading process is expedited and we're able to reload any content from our SharePoint target panel at any time. Under Additional Content, we choose whether we would like to read web parts and navigation information from the source pages. Please note that if the Read Web Parts from Pages option is unchecked, Deployer will skip reading these web parts and will not be able to deploy them to the target SharePoint 2013 environment. At present, Tsunami Deployer supports the migration of all default SharePoint web parts. When we're satisfied with our structure, we move on and Deployer begins reading the selected content into our Deployer project. Deployer is able to read all necessary content from the SharePoint server, including custom and global templates. Once Deployer is done loading, we can explore the hierarchy of the SharePoint content. Similar to the look and feel of Windows Explorer, Deployer displays the content from the source with a tree view on the left and with a list view on the right. This allows us to easily browse through our content and understand our content structure. As you can see, our site collection has been fully loaded into the project with all of its content. We can reload any items into our project that was not previously selected during the connection. For example, we can right-click on another site that has not yet been loaded and select Reload Item. The loading wizard appears again to guide us through the reload process. To connect to our target, SharePoint 2013, we use the same method as we did for loading our source, SharePoint 2010. We'll right-click the target panel and choose Connect to SharePoint. The same connection wizard appears to guide us through the process of loading the target. We select our web applications, sites, lists, and items, and load them into the project. Now that both our source and target are loaded into the project, we begin our deploy phase and start performing our virtual migration. To deploy content from our source, SharePoint 2010, to our target, SharePoint 2013, we can use several methods. The first and easiest of which is to drag and drop our selected content to the desired destination in the target. We'll select our demo site collection from SharePoint 2010 and drag it to our Tzunami site collection in SharePoint 2013. The deploy wizard appears to guide us through the process of deploying the selected items to SharePoint 2013. In the first step, we choose if we would like to deploy these files along with their security. We will deploy a basic security structure for the purposes of this demonstration. We start by specifying the global settings. In this step, we tell Deployer how to handle duplicate file names, versions, and additional advanced features. We can also choose the specific number of versions to be deployed. Under the List tab, we're able to control some of the list settings in SharePoint, such as supporting major and minor versions, attachments, and so on. In the Define Deployment Structure panel, we essentially have the ability to control the hierarchy of our items and decide how we would like for each item to be deployed. The deployer automatically suggests how to deploy the items from SharePoint 2010 to the corresponding SharePoint 2013 items. We first decide how to migrate our main site. We can choose a site template from the drop-down menu, which has all of the default SharePoint site templates, as well as the option to use custom templates. For this site, we'll choose the Team Site template and move on to determine the structure below it. Our Announcements list can be migrated as a new Announcements list. Our calendar will be migrated as a new calendar. Our document library will be migrated to the existing Documents library. Human Resources will be migrated as a subsite. Our Tasks will be migrated as a new task list. And finally, our Team Discussion will be migrated as a new discussion board. Deployer also gives us the option to migrate our content with or without the hierarchy structure. If we choose Flat Deploy, the items are all migrated on the same level and the hierarchy is not deployed. We'll now perform the security mapping, which consists of three main steps: groups mapping, entities mapping, and role mapping. We'll start with the groups mapping. In the left panel, all source groups that are relevant to the items we've deployed will appear. In the right panel, there will be a list of all target groups which are relevant to the site which we have chosen to deploy into. The bottom panel consists of pairs of source groups and target groups that have been automatically mapped by Deployer. Here we have the ability to select our own mappings using the Map button. For example, we'll select the Support Team group which exists in SharePoint 2010, and then select Create New Group in order to create a new group bearing the same name in SharePoint 2013. In the Entities Mapping step, you can map each source user or group to a target user or group. You'll notice that Marcy, Richard, and Ruth have already been intuitively mapped by Deployer. Mapping a source entity to a target entity means that the target entity will receive the same permissions that the source entity has. Here we'll map David and John to the demo members. In the final step of the security mapping, we'll map source roles to target roles. As you can see, the Deployer automatically maps the corresponding roles. The Deployer also gives us the option to add or remove different roles from the drop-down menu in the target panel. Now we'll perform the property mapping step. On the left, Deployer displays a list of properties that exist in the documents from our source SharePoint 2010 content. On the right, we can view a list of properties that are available for us from the target, SharePoint 2013. Once again, Deployer automatically suggests some of the basic mappings. Deployer enables us to map any remaining properties according to our own specifications. We now select the property from the source list and the matching property from the target list and click Map. The link above can be used in case the target has fewer properties than the source. This will tell Deployer to directly add any of the missing properties that we select to our SharePoint 2013 environment. We'll choose to maintain the owner property and all corresponding values over to our target SharePoint 2013. With this button, Deployer allows you to select one or more content types from the following list and add them to the target SharePoint 2013 list or library during your virtual deployment. The added content types that you've selected in this window will be available in the Content Type Value Mapping screen. Now that we've finished mapping our properties, we need to map the associated values of these properties. Once again, Deployer intuitively maps values in the source to target values with the same name. As we did for the property mapping step, we can select our own value mappings using the Map button. We are now ready to deploy. During this phase, Deployer applies all of the deployment settings and mappings that we've previously selected. When the deployment is finished, we can open the deploy reports. These reports allow us to view any errors or warnings that may have occurred during the virtual deployment. This enables us to make any modifications prior to the commit phase, such as changing an exceedingly long URL path or enabling a blocked extension. Since we do not have any warnings, we'll move on. We are now able to take a look at the results of the deployment. Within Deployer, we can view the properties in the target panel and confirm that the metadata associated with the items which we plan to migrate to SharePoint 2013 are all preserved according to our specifications. We'll now move on to commit our changes to SharePoint 2013. By committing our project, we tell Deployer to perform all the changes that we've made virtually and write these changes to SharePoint 2013. During the commit, the actual content migration physically copies the source items to the target library, list, or folder on the SharePoint site, while updating their metadata properties according to the Tzunami Deployer project definitions. Once the commit has finished, we'll right-click the new site and choose Open in order to open it in SharePoint via Internet Explorer. We can take a look at all the site content here and see that the migration was successful. This concludes our Tzunami Deployer demonstration for the migration of content from SharePoint 2010 to SharePoint 2013. We thank you for your time and welcome you to visit our website in order to download a free evaluation version of Tzunami Deployer for SharePoint 2013 and learn more about the Tzunami family of products.